return to the question of New York and just sort of the issues we've had about police and protest, which you, because of the responsibilities you have as a deputy commissioner, are part of. Are we making progress in terms of communication there?
I think we are. I think the idea that there has been a meeting between the union leaders and the mayor and his people and their people, and that that meeting didn't devolve into an argument but turned into a discussion about how to have a better dialogue, is step one. I think that there was a meeting yesterday in police headquarters with all the union leaders and the police commissioner and his senior staff to talk about ways going forward is a good second step. So the first step in managing any problem is, are we talking about it, and are we talking to the right people? So that's the right direction.
And on both sides, people want to make sure that they're making progress, or is there more of a sense of, you know, I'll come in screaming and kicking, but I really don't want to be here because I believe the other side is beyond reprehensible?
I've been around cops my whole life, and what I've learned about them, working with them in more than one police department and covering them as a reporter and socializing with them since I was a boy,
yes,
is that what they want more than anything is to be cops. So what we're going through here is an emotional time. They feel beat up for a whole bunch of reasons, many of which are valid. And then there's some politics involved, which always complicates things. But at the end of the day, they want to go catch bad guys. They want to do enforcement. They want to make the city safer. And here's one other rub, Charlie. This is a new generation of police officers. These aren't my father's cops. Fully 50% of them live here in New York City with their families. They can't not police this city because they live here too. And so do their wives, and so do their children, and so do their brothers and sisters and moms and dads. So I think what we're going through is something where they've tried to make a statement, but I'll tell you the second thing, which is I'm out in the car every night. And as I go from place to place, the police radio's on in the background, and I go on some of those calls, and what I'm hearing is, if there's a burglary in progress, if there's a robbery happening, if there's a victim in the street that needs help, they're going to that with every bit of speed and force as they were before this perceived slowdown. So they're getting the core job done. There's all the other parts of policing that may not be as exciting or as much fun, and that's parking tickets and speeding tickets and quality of life crimes, which are essential in Commissioner Bratton's theory of reducing overall crime. And we've seen a slowdown there, but I think the conversation about how to move past this has started.
So, okay, that says it all. The conversation how to move past it has started.
Yeah.
It's not getting deeper, it's getting
Well, I think we're at a place where some of those activities are very low. But I think the discussion about, okay, here's where we are. How do we get from here to there? And how do we get from there to the next place? I think that conversation
has
started.
How would you characterize where the mayor is in his head?
Well, I think the mayor is certainly you have to look at it on a couple of levels. Number one, here's a mayor who came in to the lowest crime numbers in the history of New York, and everybody said, watch, crime's going to go up. And then he delivered the lowest crime numbers in the history of New York. So on one hand, I think he's come to learn that he is the mayor of the city that has the most effective police department possibly on the planet Earth. So that's a good thing. On the other hand, I think the mayor is dealing with, what did they say in the movie Cool Hand Luke? I think what we're seeing here is a failure to communicate.
Yeah.
I think his statements are being interpreted by some in the worst possible light.
And perhaps he could have said it better.
And perhaps he could have said it better. And I think that you don't have to love the mayor to be an effective police department. At the end of the day, they signed up to be cops for a reason. They want to do the job. And I think that as the conversation goes forward, people will say the right things. People will hear the right things, and we'll get past this.